Hello, my name is Dr. Tiffany Powell Wiley, and I'm Chief of the Social Determinants of Obesity and Cardiovascular Risk Laboratory at the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute. Today, I will be talking about community engagement and community-based participatory research, and this is part two of a three-part series. In this session, I will provide definition and rationale for community-based participatory research, or CBPR. I will then go into key principles for community engagement in CBPR, core values of CBPR, and the application of the CBPR approach. The term community-based participatory research is used to acknowledge and emphasize the participation, influence, and control of non-academic researchers in partnership with academic researchers to create knowledge and change through research studies. And this approach is designed to equitably involve community members, community organizations, and academic researchers in all aspects of the research process. CBPR enables all partners to contribute and involves conducting research that recognizes the community as a social and cultural entity with active engagement and influence of community members in all parts of the research process. So what is the rationale for community-based participatory research? CBPR has become quite necessary as there's a greater recognition for the need for community-driven research to address health disparities. CBPR is based on a fundamental understanding of the importance of local and cultural context in the development of clinical research that has external validity and can reach those who are traditionally underrepresented in biomedical research. Additionally, CBPR helps to address complex health conditions that are influenced by social problems that are not always suited for outside expert research. These are issues that require solutions that are based on input from those most impacted by the issues. CBPR aids to provide a voice for communities most impacted by research abuse and bias, and who are most likely to mistrust the healthcare system as well as the research enterprise. Additionally, CBPR was developed to address disappointing results in intervention research that was more focused at the individual level and to get feedback from those interested in improving and working towards the health for those underrepresented, under-resourced communities. CBPR plays a particularly important role in promoting health equity. CBPR is key in working with communities most impacted by health disparities and allows for research studies to be tailored to specific community needs. CBPR works by developing partnerships with trusted community members and leaders who can help identify assets within the community that can improve health outcomes and promote health equity. These assets and resilience factors exist in all communities and can be mobilized to target issues, whether they be health-related or more structural problems that are seen by the community as contributing to health disparities. There are key principles or characteristics that can be used to guide the development of a CBPR partnership. First, CBPR requires being clear about the purpose and goals of an effort to build partnerships around research from the beginning. CBPR also builds on the strength and resources within the community. It requires a researcher to be knowledgeable about the community. For example, it is critical to recognize the skills and assets of individuals, the caring and helpful networks of social relationships that exist in communities, and the mediating structures that exist within communities like faith-based organizations or community-based organizations. And these partnerships and networks that already exist within communities can enable community members to work together to improve health and quality of life. CBPR also promotes collaborative and equitable partnerships that need to be built on trust. This starts with working with community members to identify the issues and concerns that need to be addressed. Researchers involved in CBPR recognize that inequalities that exist between themselves and community members need to be confronted from the beginning, and they also need to pay explicit attention to the expertise of community members. Researchers from academia also need to create an empowering process through sharing information, sharing decision-making power, and sharing resources amongst all members of the partnership. There are other key principles to remember for community engagement in CBPR. Those involved in CBPR recognize that self-determination is a right amongst all those within a community, and that all community members may not be willing or able to work in partnership in a research process. CBPR facilitates co-learning and capacity building to create change and improve health within a community. For example, researchers learn from the local knowledge that community members have about their community's history, culture, and broader social context, as well as from their administrative and management skills. Similarly, community members learn further skills in conducting clinical research and writing grant proposals from academic partners. CBPR also recognizes the need to balance research and action for the mutual benefit of a diverse set of stakeholders. CBPR partnerships may agree that all research efforts do not have to involve an intervention component, but they commit to the translation of research findings to intervention strategies that will address the concerns of the community. Additional key principles are that CBPR focuses on identifying and mobilizing community assets. CBPR also disseminates findings to all partners who are involved in the research process, as well as involves these partners in the dissemination process. CBPR requires releasing control of actions related to an intervention to community members and being flexible to meet the changing needs of community members. And finally, CBPR promotes a long-term process and commitment on the part of all partners to genuinely follow the principles. And CBPR emphasizes the establishment of relationships and commitments that extend beyond a single project or a single funding period. Thus, one must remember the core values of CBPR, including trust, respect, self-determination, mutuality of interests, perspective taking, full participation, reciprocity, collective benefit, and long-term commitment. It's also important to remember that CBPR is an approach to research which changes the role of the researcher and the population that is participating in research, and is designed to bring equity between the two groups. CBPR is not a specific method or set of methods, and it can involve both qualitative and quantitative methods. It can have multiple research designs. It can involve randomized trials, observational studies, or even studies that involve the treatment with therapeutics. And really, the goal of CBPR is to work across levels to change health and healthcare systems and policies that influence health. CBPR is applicable to four types of research in particular, first being descriptive research to identify multiple determinants of health, second being research to understand disparities in health status and health-related risk, the third being research to understand community needs, problems, resources, and assets, and the fourth being efforts to design, implement, and evaluate interventions and policies. In summary, CBPR involves community members, organizations, and those in academia in all aspects of the research process. CBPR is an approach to research for advancing health equity. And key principles of CBPR include being clear about goals of engagement and clear about efforts and the right to self-determination among community-based populations. So the first question is, which of the following is an important principle of community engagement for community-based participatory research? A, make certain to only tell one community leader about the purpose of your engagement and research effort. B, only spend time in the community once you have prepared your research protocol for review by community leaders. C, be clear about the purposes or goals of the community engagement effort and the populations and or communities you want to engage. D, only commit to the community engagement for the short term as long as funding remains available. And the answer is C, be clear about the purposes or goals of the engagement effort and the populations and or communities you want to engage. The next question is, which of the following statements is a part of the definition for community-based participatory research? A, equitably involves community members, organizations, and academic researchers in all aspects of the research process. B, only allow the most supportive community members to participate in research. C, ignores potential mistrust of research by community leaders. And D, involves collaborations of academic researchers to study health outcomes in a specific community. And the answer is A, equitably involves community members, organizations, and academic researchers in all aspects of the research process. Next question is true or false. Assessment of community assets and dynamics is not required in conducting community-based participatory research. And the answer is false. Next question is true or false. Community-based participatory research is a specific research method to use in working with community members on a research project. And the answer is false as well. Thank you.